Welcome back to our channel. Today we are unboxing the Cricut Maker.
Today we just got this in the mail and it's time to unbox it.
There are
a few dents in the box, but that's what the packaging is for. Seems pretty well packaged and it's kind of heavy.
Yep, it is kind of heavy.
It is double boxed. Okay. Here it is.
I decided to get the blue Cricut Maker. And now it's time to actually see what it looks like. It says that these three were included in the box. The premium fine point blade, the rotary blade, and the fine point pin. And these are the additional stuff that you could buy for the Cricut machine. Okay, the first thing that comes inside the box is this. And it says, let's get started. And I guess this is how you set it up and everything. And inside this little box, materials for your first project. Just trying to open this up. Oh, look at this. It already comes with a piece of fabric. I guess a cardstock and more paper.
Yep.
And that's, I guess, for a little project to test the machine out. There you go. You hold that. Now let's see what else. Open me first. So unleash this beauty. Get connected. Make a little something. Bookmark this page. And it has information on the back of the cards. And there is a welcome paper. It has tutorials and troubleshooting, instruction videos, and chat and email.
Yeah.
It also comes with this one tool that could be inserted in the Cricut machine. We'll put this one back here so it doesn't get lost. Cricut Maker welcome book. Let's see what's in here. Oh, little projects you could do. That's cute. Talks about the tools that you could buy for it. Here you go.
I was thinking in my head, I was like, yeah.
And let's see if there's anything under here. Oh.
There it is.
Yep. A cord. And the little pin that it comes with, and the top to
wait, it comes with a pen?
Yeah, it comes with a pin. Warranty paper. Let's try to show you how it works. Has some cardboard in there so it doesn't hit against anything. Yeah. Can you grab the box, please?
Yes.
It comes here, wrapped up, with a cute little sticker on top of it to keep it closed. And the other thing inside the box is the plug. And I did not know that it came with this, because I had bought some separate ones.
Yep.
I didn't know it was going to come with these mats. But I don't understand why. Well, yeah, I understand why they put it in the box, but the box is too small for these, so they came kind of like curled up, which really sucks, because I feel like it'll be hard to use them unless like I could bend them back, maybe put a heavy book on it or something, try to straighten it out a little so that I could use them with no problem. But both of them are really bent. They were lying in the box like this, underneath the Cricut machine. But now it's time to move on to the machine and see how it looks. Cute. Ooh. Wow. This machine is a lot heavier than I expected it to be. But it's good to know that it's pretty sturdy. And wow, this is really awesome that they put like shrink wrap on it. So it's completely sealed. So nothing, no dirt or any dust or anything to get inside of it. But I'm gonna remove that. It has some storage right here on the side of it where you can put some of your tools. I decided to get the blue color because it's my favorite color and I love it. Very beautiful. Ooh. Oh, I like that it has this piece of foam right here, so that it does not mess these up when it's shipping. There's extra storage space right here. Okay, I'm gonna put it right there. Let's see. Oh, yeah, it's got a very handy storage place. The little cubby hose that you could put, well, just pretend this is a tool. There is also a spot for your phone or your tablet. Well, my phone's in a case, so it doesn't fit, but if you don't have a case on yours, it'll probably fit. And it has these latches that you could open and close. And that's how you remove them. And to place it back in, you do the same. You place it, you move that, and you close this. It is extremely durable. It feels very durable. Like, I don't feel like it's gonna break or anything. It's kind of a little hard to open and close the right amount of pressure needed to do it. And this is where you add the pin. It just opens like that, and oh, let me grab the pin. And then you just add it until it clicks, and then you close it. Now it is time to plug it up and see how this works. I really love how sleek and nice this machine looks, but it is still very sturdy and it has some weight to it. That is a USB outlet, which is pretty cool. I feel like I could use it to charge my phone or something. I just turned it on. That's something new. To set up your new machine, all you have to do is go to the App Store and download the app Cricut Design Space. Once Cricut Design is installed, just choose machine setup and you need to pick which machine you have, and I have a Cricut Maker. Next, you need to create a Cricut ID using your email, your name, and a password. Also, make sure that your Bluetooth is turned on because you need to connect it to your Cricut Maker. And it is that simple, setting up your Cricut device using an iPad.
I just decided to skip the test cut, but you could do it if you want to. I went ahead and just clicked on new project because I decided just to use my own photo that I saved to make a Spider-Man mask for my niece. Now that I have the design, I must click on remove and click on the areas that I want to cut out. Like, I don't want the background, so I cut out the background and all the little spaces in between the web. There is also a little box on the right hand corner that shows you what the design currently looks like. Now press next, and it is time to smooth out any rough edges. My design is now complete and I can move on to the next step. Now all I have to do is insert the image and resize it, then press make.
Okay, we are going to use Cricut Everyday Iron-On and a standard grip mat. And you gotta save the plastic for later because you gotta put it back on so it doesn't get all dirty. Okay, a learner's mistake. We're gonna put the shiny side down instead of outwards.
You found the smallest version?
Yeah, I did.
Well, where are them? I was like, where are they?
So I decided just to cut a small piece out of it because I thought it would be a little bit easier to handle since it is my first time using the Cricut. Okay, since I don't have one of those scraping tools, I'm just going to use this card and try to get all the air bubbles out. Huh, there we go. If you are using the iron-on vinyl, you must turn the mirror on. I just loaded my mat back into the machine, and I believe I just pressed this button. This is going to be our first iron-on, see how it comes out. What? Oh, okay, never mind. It does not look like it's cutting, but we will find out once it's done. Oh, I think it's making it really, really small.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. Like, super tiny. Okay, we got the sizing wrong, I think. Oh, that's gonna be crazy if it comes out really small. It might take a while. It did have a lot of little details. We're hoping that it fits on this little mask. It's almost done cutting. Oh, moment of truth. Oh, you could kind of see it. That's pretty cool. I do not have any of the Cricut tools right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and use whatever I have at home. And what I have is a dental oral kit. So we're gonna see if this works. It has a small little tip like the one that I saw. Might try to get the tools later on, but I did not have a chance to grab them. Don't forget to put your plastic back on. I'm gonna see if this actually works for the to pull off the vinyl. This has so much detail in it, so I'll just show you pulling off the big one. And it's probably not gonna work. Ooh, it works. Okay, it's really tiny,
It has a lot of detail, so I will just show you.
Okay, this is what the finished cutout looks like, but I still have to iron it on, and I do not have a heat press, so I am just using a regular iron, and they said to set it at cotton and linen, and we will try it and see if it works. Okay, I'm gonna cover it so it doesn't burn. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's see how this goes.
Awesome.
That looks really nice though. On the other side of her mask. Okay, after using the Cricut for the third time, I could say that I really, really love the machine a lot. I made this shirt for my husband. And it came out really, really good, and it's so easy and simple to use. I love this machine, and I really appreciate my sister for getting it for me as a gift. I would have never thought that it would be so cool, so I'm super excited to work on any future projects and just to learn how to use it. If you're thinking about getting it, I think that it's a really good investment, but it is on the more expensive side, so it is a very expensive hobby. So maybe consider buying it if you want to make your own stickers or t-shirts, or like if you draw, you could just add your own designs on the t-shirt. This is not my own design, but I just made it for my husband, so it's okay. All the extra stuff that I got, I spent $100 easily on just vinyl. Iron-on vinyl is more expensive. I did buy mats. The mats are not too bad because they're reusable, and they're like $15 for a pack of two, which isn't that bad. But if I knew before I was thinking about getting it that it was this great, I probably would have saved up money a lot sooner just to get it. So, and it sticks onto the shirt so good.
These are some of the other Cricut projects I have worked on. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video.